Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, let's cover the current affairs of 12th of April. So let's start the video. Now you can follow me on Facebook. I'm available on facebook.com/gauravgargeducation. I'm also available on Instagram. My ID is tireless soul. First question is about International Monetary Fund. So International Monetary Fund has lowered its global growth forecast for 2019 to what percent? They were saying earlier that the global growth will be 3.5%. Now they have decreased it by 20 basis points or 0.2 percentage points to 3.3. So remember, according to IMF, the global growth will be 3.3. What about India? According to IMF, India's GDP will grow in the current financial year at 7.3%. According to Reserve Bank of India, 7.2%. And according to World Bank, 7.5%. So the good thing is that minimum we will grow in the coming financial year, in the present financial year, at minimum 7%, right? RBI 7.2, World Bank 7.5, IMF 7.3. The new president of World Bank is Mr. David Malpass, and he is from America. IMF and World Bank both are headquartered in Washington, D.C., and they both are called Bretton Woods twins. Which company has introduced a new open platform, which is called Anthos, to run and manage apps from anywhere? Anthos and Stadia, both are launched by Google. Now remember, Stadia is a cloud gaming platform. Super important. Cloud gaming platform of Google is called Stadia. And the new open platform is called Anthos, and both are by Google. Facebook is launching a satellite called Athena. This is to provide internet across the globe. Who has been appointed as the chairman and managing director of the public sector company called National Buildings Construction Corporation, NBCC? Who? His name is Mr. Shiv Das Meena. B.A. Sanat passed away. He was a famous what? Now remember, in these type of questions, most of the times the answer is either a writer or a politician. So if you want to take a guess, then these are guesses worth taking. You know, these questions are not meant to be left. So he was a writer. And he used to write in Kannada language, which is the state language of Karnataka. Recently, there was a super hit movie called Uri, The Surgical Strike. In that movie, the actor who played the role of Home Minister, Rajnath Singh, he passed away. What was his name? He was a very good actor. His name was Navtej Hundal. And of course, the main role in Uri was played by Vicky Kaushal. India has built a hospital called Chandra Narayan Yadav Memorial Maternity Hospital in which country? And so usually countries, they build hospitals in other countries as a mark of respect or for mutual cooperation in healthcare. So this has been done in Nepal. Now this hospital was inaugurated by India's ambassador to Nepal, Mr. Manjeev Singh Puri. Now remember, these four are the most important ambassadors that every exam asks you, right? Nepal, America, Pakistan and China, right? Because these four are the most important countries for us. So our ambassador to America is Harshvardhan Shringla. Our high commissioner to Pakistan is Ajay Bisaria. I'm using the word high commissioner here because Pakistan is a Commonwealth country. So in Commonwealth country, we don't use the word ambassador. We use the word high commissioner. That is the only difference between ambassador and high commissioner. China, Indian ambassador to China is Vikram Mishri. And India's ambassador, very, very latest to Seychelles, is Dalvir Suhag, the former army chief. This has been done to increase our say in the Indian Ocean. Name the famous actress. She started in two James Bond movies, From Russia with Love and Goldfinger. She passed away recently. What was her name? Her name was Nadja Regan. A lot of actors, they have played James Bond over the years. Like right now it is Daniel Craig, before it Pierce Brosnan, then Roger Moore. You know, there was one very famous one, the first one, I'm forgetting his name. Roger Moore, Pierce Brosnan, right now Daniel Craig, and the most famous one, I'm forgetting his name. Okay, we'll see. The United Kingdom and the European Union have agreed to extend Brexit deal until what? So basically, United Kingdom will remain a part of European Union for now and at least till 31st of October. Actually, this is a big defeat for Theresa May. Her entire career was based on Brexit and she was defeated by her own party people in the voting. So huge setback for Theresa May. Who was selected for the prestigious Saraswati Samman for his collection of poetry, which is called Pakkaki Oti Jilit? Okay. Pakkaki Oti Jilit is a collection of poems in Telugu by K. Sivareddy. So K. Sivareddy has got Saraswati Samman 2018. Name the WikiLeaks founder who was arrested in the Ecuadorian embassy in London because Ecuador have withdrawn the citizenship they had given to this person. His name is Julian Assange. Julian Assange. The Supreme Court of India, they have put a fine of how much amount on the West Bengal government because they were banning a movie called Bobby Shot There Bhoot. This movie was banned by the West Bengal government. So Supreme Court have fined the West Bengal government. And the amount is 20 lakh rupees. 20 lakh rupees. It's basically a satirical film. Okay, and the fine will go to the producers and cinema hall owners for compensation of violation of their right of to freedom. Now recently, you know that this photo of black hole was released by NASA. So astronomers, they took the first ever image of black hole with the help of which telescope? Which telescope was used to take the photo of the black hole? It is Event Horizon Telescope. Event Horizon Telescope. Benjamin Netanyahu, he became the Prime Minister of Israel once again. Now this was his record which term? So he has become the Prime Minister for fifth time. Okay, fifth time. However, this time the elections were very closely fought, you know. So Netanyahu, his party is Likud party. Likud party. He is basically a right, far right leader. India and which country, they have launched a joint program to collaborate on the solutions for smart cities. Now in India, 100 smart cities will be built. 100th smart city was Shillong, right? Although not even a single smart city has been made till now, but India is on course to make 100 smart cities. And this project is undertaken by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. The country that will help us is Sweden. Sweden. Okay, let me ask you a difficult question. Who is a 16-year-old environmentalist from Sweden who has been nominated for our Nobel Peace Prize? She has not won it yet. She has been nominated. What is her name? This is a tough question. Abdelkader Bensalah. Abdelkader Bensalah has become the interim president of which country recently? He is the interim president of Algeria. Algeria. Who was appointed as the first Chief Justice of the new Andhra Pradesh High Court? So after the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Act of 2014, when Telangana was created, the Hyderabad High Court has been given to Telangana. So Andhra Pradesh, they have made their own High Court in Amaravati. Clear? The first Chief Justice of new Andhra Pradesh High Court is Mr. Vikram Nath. Vikram Nath. According to UNFPA report, India's population has grown at an average annual rate of how much percent between 2010 and 2019? What has been the average annual growth rate? It has been 1.2% according to United Nations Population Fund. 1.2%. Government, they have retained the interest rate for General Provident Fund at what percent? If you know, what will be the interest that you will get in your Provident Fund? Now remember, the interest rate on these small savings, you know, like Sukanya Samriddhi or Provident Fund or all of these, they are always changed every 3 months, you know. So the government, they appraise the interest rates on various small saving schemes. They might change it, they might not, but it is reviewed every 3 months. So on Provident Fund we will get 8%. And these four are also very important, especially if you're preparing for any bank exam. Now SBI PO mains is coming up, so one of the interest rates will surely be asked. Sukanya Samriddhi account, you will get 8.5%. Kisan Vikas Patra, 7.7%. Senior Citizen Savings Scheme, 8.7%. And National Savings Certificate, 8%. KM Money passed away. He was related to which field? K.M. Mani was a Congress politician from Kerala. So the answer is he represented politics. India's next education technology startup. India's which education technology startup has bagged the next billion EdTech prize? This prize was recently given to Dost Education. Who is the author of the book called Rukat-e-Alamgiri? Rukat-e-Alamgiri was written by Aurangzeb. It was written by Aurangzeb. Which five-year plan is also known as Gadgil Yojana? Gadgil Yojana. It is the third five-year plan. Third five-year plan, 1961 to 1966. Okay, so this was the video for 12th of April. I hope you gained something from it. See you in my next video. And now I'm available on facebook.com/gauravargeducation and on Instagram on this ID tirelesssoul.